Well, there's still more. You're saying slash now. Don't worry. I'm prepared for slash.
Okay, I'll get to all.
You two aren't going to be going in, but your passes will probably help Ryoshu. And if need be, I can tag y'all in, because... What are you doing here? The room, now without its master, was completely turned upside down. And in the dead center of the mess were butlers, awkwardly standing frozen mid-movement as though they'd all been caught red-handed. We were cleaning the room, as per Master Linton's orders. You lot were clearly ransacking the room. Chief Butler Nelly, have you seen any of the dead rabbits or Wuthering Heights butlers on your way here? We have good reason to believe that Wuthering Heights butlers are scheming with that villain Hindley to harm Master Linton. The dead rabbits ain't the type of gang to kill people for no reason. Okay. But they did try to kill us for no reason. I know, damn it. Boss can't be doing this all for nothing. He must have a good explanation for this. Just tell us what a dodgy shite like you were up to in Catherine's room. We told you, Heathcliff. We were cleaning the room. Or have you sided yourself with the rest of those lowlives, the dead rabbits? Like master, like butlers, eh? Just as stupid and soft as Linton himself. That was uncalled for. No, this dodgy shite you're trying to pull here is what's uncalled for. You've crossed the line. I'm the only one who can tell you what to do with this room. Not that posh wanker.
잘 됐다. 그치?
적출할게요.
Blade Lineage prepared me for this.
효율적인 대처로 개체를 꿰뚫었습니다. 참고로 기계는 입에 발린 말 따위 쉽게 하지 않아.
어떻게 하신 거죠?
다음번에는 깜짝 놀랐어요. 뺄 수 있겠죠?
우와. 카론도 깜짝.
조심하랬지? 버리겠습니다.
효과적이네요. 이 방식을 기억하는 게 좋겠어요.
깎는다. 6천.
칼날이 잘 드네요.
아마 그 공격이 약점이었겠죠?
맘.
대성공이야. 칼은 신나. 노래 부를까?
아까 했던 공격 덕에 한결 수월해진 것 같아요. 좋네요.
망설임이 없도록.
We've yet to have a focused encounter of any sorts, which I kind of expected to when they showed, like, affinity weaknesses instead of blunt and whatnot. I mean, it's not even as late as it was yesterday, but I feel even more tired, probably because I stayed up late the other night. Also, what the fuck? Leave Gregor alone. Do those two.
뺀다면 사활을 건다. 자.
Come on, Heath.
된다고 할 수는 없지만 여러분은 하실 수 있을 거예요.
네, crap. I made sure I got this. I wasted so many boxes.
된다면 사활을 건다.
전문가 And it does 자, so well.
이걸로 대신하지.
I love that animation, the pullback of the face. Just oh, it does. And it heals.
뼈를 끊는다.
Okay.
핫! 벌써 끝나간군.
뼈를 끊는다.
그만해, 히스클리프!
That's enough, Heathcliff.
살려는 놔야 해요.
We can't kill her, otherwise we won't know what they were looking for, or why.
말해,
Speak. I'm going to take your utensils and cut off your fingers one by one with each dodgy answer you give me. You must know how sharp your own blades are.
말해줄래?
Please cooperate, won't you? I don't want to have to use sleepy smack on my own subordinates. The diary. Master Linton told us that we must find the diary in Mistress Catherine's room. That she must have hidden her diary somewhere in here, and they were making modifications. As they were making modifications to the manor. I see. So why do you think Master Linton's looking for that diary? Master Linton told us that it was to find a way. Please do keep your mysterious attitude. A few more answers like that, and I will personally demonstrate how I managed to become the chief butler. It's the truth. He did not let us in on what this way is. I have told you all I know. That's it. Looks like I'll have to. That's enough, Heathcliff. I believe that she is telling the truth. All of you leave us. Now. And please do stay out of my sight. Chief Butler Nelly. According to what intelligence we could gather, the dead rabbits, the syndicate of the Irvin Plague classification, had long been obliterated from the Tea Court bastards. Huh? What? They had been inactive for a long time. For a long, long time. In other words, they have already been vanquished. Other gangs have not seen the dead rabbits in the back streets in a while either. We have no way of verifying their identities. Please do be careful. Who in the places did Master Henley lead into this manor? In that diary. A diary, huh? I'm not sure what to expect from it, but if we do find it, it'd at least be a clue as to what kind of situation we've walked into. A small container, a space to hide such things as a diary, would be these bookshelves or drawers, but it appears that the butlers have combed this room clean already. I have once beheld such a sight. Forsooth, it is often the case that a hidden button exists somewhere. We ought to scour this room from corner to corner with a magnifying glass, much larger than even Gregor's. These are glasses for myopia? Myopia. Nearsightedness. Hey, me and Gregor have the same stigmatism. There are 1,000 feathers of so many birds in this pillow.
다른 부자들은 희귀한
Other people mean like to collect rare bird feathers and stuff their pillows with them. But I don't like that. Do you know why?
날아가는 새들은
Because birds are meant to fly, not to be killed like that.
맞아.
Yes, birds do not belong in their cages. They belong. They are beings born to soar the skies. So I am glad to empty this pillow of their feathers. Instead, I will fit it with my secret, so that I will always have it at arm's reach. Heathcliff, why are you tearing that pillow open? This is where Kathy would have. A diary hidden within a pillow.
커다란 얼룩이 번져 있네요.
It's stained by ink, even the cover too.
왜 이런 얼룩들이 배어 있는 거지?
I wonder why anyone would do this to their own diary.
아주 오랫동안 무슨 글을 써야 할지 몰라서
When I would hold my pen against the paper for a long time because I'm not sure what to write, the ink will start to pool and spread, leaving big stains like these. These stains appear to have been made from a non-stained special ink. A pool of ink that stained this page has left no marks on the subsequent pages. Perhaps these stains were made on purpose to hide the words underneath them. If then Linton's guy is trying so hard to find this diary, then I'm willing to bet that it's something important. Most of these pages are all stained. True, most of the pages were stained, and their contents were rather difficult to read. I would have liked to read them even a little bit. That's when the pages suddenly began flipping rapidly until it came to a stop at a page with actually legible words. It couldn't have been the wind. There weren't any open windows. Heathcliff left me without a word. A terrible thunderstorm rages outside. Will he cease to pain my heart and return home once the rain passes, like Nelly said? Fine. Don't come back. I don't want to see your face ever again either. This manor and me were all you have. You don't have anything else. Will you truly abandon what is everything to you? Boy, this all feels extremely private. Should we? Why don't we leave Heathcliff alone so he can... No. The century seems off. A guest paid me a visit, the first in a long time. Conversing with someone new really cleared my head. And I saw my shape in the mirror before me. I know what to do now. The basement. We must descend there. What do you think this week? Who do you think this we is? The basement. The basement.
Nelly.
From what I remember, Nelly. I agree, Heathcliff. Everyone, it appears that our destination lies at the basement of this manor. What makes you say that? The old mistress, who passed away many years ago, ordered us to seal the entrance to the basement. Which means that the basement was unsealed when the modifications were made to the manor. But why? Why the basement? Kathy's hated the dark, even to keep her room, enough to keep her room always lit with several lanterns. Indeed, and I recall having to purchase an entire set of lanterns whenever I left the manor to procure the groceries. That is certainly suspicious. Got any idea of how... As to where we might find the basement, Nelly? Well, it's usually by the kitchen, isn't it? Let's investigate that place first, shall we? Yeah, let's do these.
몸 좀 풀어보자고.
가스 점화! 엔진 시동!
We had a rather spirited start to the investigation, but our journey to the kitchen was far from straightforward. Odd, from what I recall, turning right here should have led us to the first floor. No, we should have found the kitchen ages ago. And Nelly, it makes absolutely no sense that you of all people would be lost here. Indeed, you could have blindfolded me and I would still know where everything in this house is. This feels quite familiar. It is like the corridor. Indeed, like the corridors of the back door. Yes, considering the exterior of the manor and comparing it to its internal map, its shape and size, it's far from being even remotely reasonable. What's on your mind, Heathcliff? This feels familiar, like it's all just one big riddle Kathy used to give me. I sometimes get the right answer early in the game, and every time I did, she kept making the answers more and more convoluted. Annoyed that I actually managed to get it right. This is exactly what it feels like. Like she's cross with me, hiding the basement from us, making us go in circles. Darn it, let me see that diary. I want to see if it says anything else about the basement. This is like the third time we've walked through this hallway, okay? I'm starting to lose my cool. Look, that picture frame again. Oh, I could recognize you from anywhere now. There wasn't anything else in this diary, in the diary last. Just let me have a look, Keith. What if you missed something? Don't? Was that overreaction really necessary, Don Quixote? What the heck was that? A window shattered, quite literally out of nowhere. Oh, my bad, Heath. I dropped the diary. The noise really got me. Don't bother. I just need to dust it lightly. Huh? Wait, this page wasn't here earlier. Page was one of those ink-stained pages, wasn't it? The basement. We must descend there. In a not-so-far future, I would like to hang my portrait at the entrance of that basement. A portrait of my most beautiful, most spirited, yet leading present himself. In those rare days when Josephine wasn't haunting that area of the manor, I'd sit there for hours with him by my side, just chatting our day away. Do you remember those days? This is a riddle, isn't it? So where could this be? If this is her riddle, then the only one who can solve it has to be the entrance of the basement, just chatting our days away. Heathcliff briefly closed his eyes, as if to recall what these could be referring to, then squinted them open. The fireplace in the dining hall. Catherine enjoyed chatting with me before the fireplace. I see. Those moments must have been very precious to her. Precious enough to write about them in her diary so that she will always remember them. You lot again. Where is he? Where's boss? Any further attempts to communicate with them appear futile. They're clearly... No. The dead rabbits, they... Heathcliff stopped himself, then scratched his head and sighed deeply. Damn it. Suppose it doesn't matter what I've got to say. I don't know. None of this feels real. They're saying that Kathy's dead, the dead rabbits have changed, and this bloody maze of a manor... Okay. You know, sometimes I'm like disappointed when we hit the wall. But boy, I need a break. And the only reason I'm avoiding taking one is just because it feels like we're gonna be close to a wall. I'll give chapter 5 something. I think it was very well paced. Chapter 5, I think, was very, very well paced. One is kinda short. Two is probably a decent length as well. Like, there's a sweet spot, I think. Three is a little long, 4 is almost too long. Actually, more than almost too long. It's kind of just becomes too much by the end of it. But chapter 5 was definitely like a very good sweet spot amount. Damn. So I was hoping they would just repeat that going forward for their pacing, but I'm almost worried that it's going to be more bloated like 4. Damn. Down, Stagger! Gotta love it. I absolutely just need to go lay down now. This has also been a lot. I'm gonna get through this and I'll do a discussion after and maybe cut some of my prior bits out from previous parts just because. Wait, also, really? Keep forgetting to do this, but sorry, Angela. You talk too much. It's just too much. I can't. K Corp only to take more hits than Don Cube. W Corp. What? I think she hits harder. There already was a group of people by the fireplace.
Linton Jr.
Mr. Linton. So you've arrived. This can't be a coincidence, can it? I suppose you're also trying to enter the basement. Master Linton, what are you hiding in the basement? I see that they've gotten their hands on it first, despite the fact that you had the head start. Our most profound apologies, Master Linton. Return that diary to me. Why must we? Is it that unreasonable for a husband to request that you return his loving wife's memento to his hands? Don't provoke me. Tell me why Catherine died. And like I said earlier, I won't believe a word from her gob until I see her for myself. Even your claim that she married you. How desperate. Allow me to offer you an alternative. Go hide in some corner of this manor, wait until the lightning strikes seven times, and then take the golden ball Captain left for you. Leave and never return to this place ever again. It is what you do best, Heathcliff. Turning tail and hiding. Shredding your shameful, tear-soaked face from the world. Fleeing from the beatings, abandoning Catherine, because you were too busy running away from the gnawing hounds. Keep talking, young Master Edgar, and you'll find that I'm no longer that weak child you once knew. Well, I'm not so sure what has really changed about you since then, Heathcliff. And those cheap, tacky letters you sent. Ooh, he read the letters.
소각장에 태워질 뿐이지.
All burned with the rest of the trash in the incinerator.
유감 없는 싸움을 기대하겠소.
Honestly, could be both. I kind of don't like how sympathetic-ish they're trying to make Kevin out to be, because I don't find her to be a sympathetic character.
외우피의 적법한 무력 행사다.
대사를 베어내고.
벌써 끝나간군.
저들이 추풍과 같이 흔들려 보다 유리하지 않겠어.
From what was said prior, both Bookheath and Limbusheath left not from the beatings, but from her own words. So,
헛! 샤!
칼날이 잘 드네요. 아마 그 공격이 약점이었겠죠?
걱정 마시오. 최후의 혈구 하나만 남아 있다면 생명은 어떻게라도 보존될 테니.
내가 눈에 새겨주지.
Close his heart.
방해꾼 하나가 사라졌군.
살을 베어내고.
Is this a struggle fight?
자!
It was basically today-ish that I saw Dean Linton.
이런 상황인데도. 어떻게 끝이 보이네요.
ID for Gregor.
조금만 더 해보죠.
된다면 사활을 건다.
So that's out now. You have a health.
육창 뼈를 끊는다.
Still not dead.
버리겠습니다.
뼈를 끊는다.
I did register that Josephine fight, kind of. I wish there was more to it, but
Mom,
she didn't die, so. Could still have more to that fight. Cooking now, people.
된다면 사활을 건다.
자, for things there. Goddamn, it's in there.
Iron, 동료들 상태에 신경 좀 쓰셔야 할 것 같은데요, 관리자님.
된다면 사활을 건다. 육천.
승객이 딱콩 한 방 먹였어.
살을 베어내고.
영원히.
동화 하나 읽어줄까?
야호, 이기는 편, 우리 편.
Sam and London's jumping in at the end.
적출할게요.
Wait, I didn't look at the wave count. And it went away before I could peek
it. 버리겠습니다.
효과적이네요. 이 방식을 기억하는 게 좋겠어요. 하!
완전히 녹아내렸네.
외우피의 적법한 무력 행사다.
헛! 자!
맘.
뼈를 끊는다.
배워냈어요.
미피가 배고파했어.
My screen. No lint in here, so I'm not getting his hands dirty quite yet. So either he's not gonna fight us, or there's one more after this. Ooh, I forgot I had this one equipped. Let's play with it. Oh, I didn't realize this one hit more than one. Granted, a few times I have used it, that I was fighting big bosses that are only one thing, so. Wait. Oh, wait. That.
Sorry,
almost missed it. Come on here.
외우피의 적법한 무력 행사다.
아, 그래. 스타일. Was hoping he'd go off before then.
상황이 좋다고 할 수는 없지만 여러분은 하실 수 있을
거예요. Sinclair died. Damn, I'm gonna have to redo this for EX, aren't I?
내가 눈에 새겨주지.
육창.
방해꾼 하나가 사라졌군.
You bet. Like they're not hard. They're just annoying.
다시 복구하긴 힘들걸요?
I'm not hitting him hard enough. Like I'm winning, but I'm also struggle bussing to just get rid of their health. Or I'm not losing. That's actually better. I let the Ingu stay. I officially spent it and completely lost it. Shit. I thought it was just locked in.
So Yuria Gurio.
Chuck Trakia.
How is it?
It's a tickle of the Kanguji.
Okay. What have you done to this manor? I did not tamper with the manor myself. I have not once been anywhere near the subject of the workshops or engineering in my life. I am but a sheltered child of the esteemed Edgar family. How would I have the capacity to do the modifications myself? All I have done is make a few investments in a separate organization that worked on the construction. They were introduced to me as a group as part of this syndicate called the Ring. Oh, another ring. The Ring? Didn't the Dead Rabbits guy say something about being plucked by the Ring? What the hell are you doing bringing those blighters here? I don't know. I never really cared much about the details of how this manor was modified, but if my brother found out what I was doing, he would have tried to kill me, but I cared not. I never really cared much about the details of how this banner was modified. If my brother found out what I was doing, he would have tried to kill me, but I cared not. Interesting, because Linton didn't have a brother, he had a sister. Who he's got with, so they just made it into a brother? Who may or may not show up? How did you even come across the golden ball? It's impossible for a private individual to acquire the golden ball, indeed. But the Edgar family is a family of vast means. When my eldest brother left, I don't remember him having an older brother. I guess it's pretty easy to mess with a family tree, but... Huh. And maybe he did have one, but it was not as involved. Edgar family, Wuthering Heights. Not Edgar family. Granted, they're playing as Edgar family, but it's Linton family. Yeah, it's only the two, Edgar and Isabel. Okay, I'm curious as to how this brother situation might come back in. I mean, it's fine to like mess with it. I'm just like, okay, instead of younger sister, older brother. When my eldest brother left, most of the family fortune became mine. I quite enjoyed the affluence. One could say that it's the only thing in my possession that I liked, though I have spent most of it procuring the golden ball. Linton was coughing harshly between every couple of words. It seemed as though he was pushing himself to finish a sentence. It wasn't that the battles had been grueling, it was merely that he was someone of a frailer constitution. Okay, this is also coming back to, I think they've overlapped the child Linton version with this Linton. The Edgar family, I believe that I've once witnessed a name in the Fixer's monthly magazines, mayhaps? Huh. What have I got to say to a bloke who looks like he belongs in the infirmary? Just tell me what happened to Catherine. That's all I'm asking. Do you really think that you even deserve to meddle in my family's affairs? To meddle in this business between me and my wife? Don't talk like that to me, damn it. What are you trying to flaunt those words in or something? We were married. De facto de jure. De facto de jure. De facto I get. What is de jure? I'm looking things up because I want to know them as they come up. What is the meaning of de jure? By right of. I was Catherine's lawfully wedded husband, and we lived under the same roof. We built the family together. Right, husband. I suppose you will never know how it feels to be called that. Am I wrong? It's only expected at this point, is it not? Who in their right mind would leave everything behind just to be with some poor backstreet's vagrant like you? I told you to stop provoking me. It's... Damn it. Hazeless fell silent for a moment. What Henley said, Linton said, must that I confusing Henley and Linton, good lord. Okay. Hazeless fell silent for a moment. What Linton said hurt him so much that he could not even come up with a rebuttal. Linton continued, somewhat emboldened by his silence. You were the first to leave her, yes. But I assure you, it was certainly for the better. Because she would have left you first if you hadn't. Because she would have grown tired of you. Tired of me? And you said that on purpose, didn't you? What do you mean? Just now, you provoked Heathcliff. So that you'll anger that boy so that he'll attack you first. No, I never said anything to him. You see, I was just talking to Henley. Besides, let's be honest. Just look at him. His unkept hair, the rags he's wearing, he's laughable, isn't he? Do you even know what you've done? Henley will thrash that boy once you leave. Do you understand? No. Quit your weeping, Linton. You have no idea how happy, unhappy your tears make me. Linton tortures Heathcliff like that on purpose. Every time my brother speaks ill of Heathcliff, he giggles with him or mutters in agreement, as if he wants Heathcliff to hear. And Heathcliff would always attack Linton, because he is an impulsive child. Why can't the people I love also love one another? Linton, you love me, don't you? Of course, dear Catherine. Then how far are you willing to go for love? What does love mean to you? If you truly love me, then perhaps you could go... could bring Heathcliff back to me. That diary. You can read it. Linton looked downright pathetic. He was gasping for air with every breath, trying to read the open diary. It was a wretched sight, the rapier in his hand clattering pitifully to the floor. Yeah, as you can plainly see yourself. When I tried to read it, it was full of nothing but pages upon pages of ink stains. So why does it refuse me but not... Catherine, this is your answer then. I no longer know if I even and have the right to stand in your way. Linton closes his eyes for a moment and backs away from us. He activates the button somewhere within the fireplace, and the fireplace opens loud with the sound of moving mechanical parts before us appears a long staircase leading downstairs. He is watching us with a hollow, dejected look. Master Linton, the staircase leads to the basement. What the hell are you doing down there? What the hell were you doing down there? All I can say is that I have been preparing to invite a new guest. Descend, whatever appears before you, whatever transpires, it shall all be as Catherine willed. Okay. And we've officially hit a wall. I'm not entirely convinced Catherine's dead. Or at the very least, I think it might be a Yuri-ish situation. Potentially the Golden Ball, keeping her alive, living corpse style, the Golden Balls are very confusing. Linton also saying he was getting ready to invite a new guest, so potentially some other character coming? I swear if they bring the daughter, I'm gonna scream. But yeah, I don't quite get it. I don't quite get where some of this is going. I was kind of thinking we would run into the Dead Rabbit's leader again, Matt, because he's not a Wuthering Heights character from what I can see. getting what I remember, just like there's not really anyone named Matt there. So I want to explore more of that and Heathcliff's past with them as well. Granted, they're also related to the ring and the fingers and the but the fact that the ring came to do the modifications on the manor, the ring also seemingly plucked the dead rabbits out. This all really seems like one big thing that the ring set up. Something that they wanted. Mayhaps. Catherine's definitely set up to be, I think, a bit more sympathetic, but at the same time, I'm waiting for the other shoe to drop. Like, Heathcliff has already said he left because of what she said. So when are we going to get that? We get little glimpses of Catherine defending Keith from Linton and Henley, and knowing Henley will beat on Heathcliff, and she was well aware of that. But she absolutely, I feel like, would have also thrown some vitriol his way. They fought. And I feel like this is also playing it more sympathetically, where Catherine just wants the people that she loves to get along or love one another. But in the books, it's almost played off as more of Catherine just wants to. I always got the impression of Catherine just wants to be loved. And she doesn't necessarily like the people around her fighting, but her wanting Linton's love and Heathcliff's love is more of having my cake and eating it too than I just want you two to get along. There's a reason that the ego chosen for Heathcliff is the binds. Him being bound to the chair, bound to her, bound to potentially Wuthering Heights in some manner, but I think he more so got away from that. It's more so bound to Catherine.